is the capital of the Ural region, and we are really one of the biggest producing centers in the entire Russia. We are on the border between Europe and Asia, and an artist, Ulay, who came to organize his exhibition, his pioneering performance artist to Ekaterinburg, made a very poetic name that Ekaterinburg is the city where the sun of Asia rises for Europe. National Center for Contemporary Art is the first institution officially established for contemporary art after Perestroika in 1992, and it's the first government-based museum working with contemporary art under the Ministry of Culture, Russian Federation. In the beginning of 2000s, things really changed. NCCA started as well as a pioneering institution, but it became a driver for the local situation and many artist-run spaces. That's the mission which I was talking since the very beginning, that to change the center from the margins, to put the local situation on the international map, art map, to work with the audience, to educate people, and to give an opportunity to learn about the entire world. And that's why I want to talk about texture as urban surface. So the main texture which I work in with, it's actually the city and the urban textile. And this is a picture from the last biennial by German artist. Everybody doing selfie now. And she just put a room covered full of the mirrors. And in every from every point where you could would like to do a selfie, it the city landscape would be reflected in this mirror. So it always will be a selfie with the city on your back. We decide that maybe really most important thing which biennial can bring to the city, it's even not all this, you know, like 60 artists, 100 artists, 300 artists, but this new optic which you would propose to people to look differently on the really common things which you are used to live with. And this it's a nice example of provoking the people by a group of artists called Zergut, and it was their symbolical entrance to the city because they moved to Ekaterinburg from suburban city Nizhny Tagil, and they decide to make it symbolically as a marriage with the city. And for me it's really important when we are talking about this urban meanings that the city is something so meaningful that you can even marry the city.